Hi, my name is Shelley, and I'm with Sailors for the Sea powered by Oceana. Today, we're going to build a simple piece of scientific equipment to measure the water clarity or turbidity in the water. Turbidity is essentially the amount of particles floating in the water, which can be sediment being stirred up or even microscopic plankton. Turbidity can increase due to high winds and strong currents that mix up the sediments, and it can also happen when there's a rainfall that brings sediments into the water. Most of the time, if there's high levels of turbidity, it's caused by man-made sources, which can be runoff from agriculture, mining, or eroding soil, and blooms of plankton caused by high levels of nutrients that are going into the water. When turbidity is high, so when the water is very cloudy, plants on the seafloor have trouble getting enough sunlight to survive. Turbidity can also reduce the visibility for fish that rely on their vision or even clog their gills. Today we're going to make a secchi disc to measure the turbidity of the water. For materials, you just need the following items. To build the secchi disc, you first cut the sides off the three pie plates and glue them all together. Next, you are going to paint the disc, alternating black and white for the four equal quadrants. Then you cut a hole through the plate and run the line through so there's about a foot of line out the bottom. The painted side is on the top. Tie a knot at the base of the disc and then tie the weight off securely at the bottom of the line. To measure turbidity, you need to mark the line. Start at the top side of the disc and use a permanent marker to color a black line every 5 centimeters and a red line every 50 centimeters. Now we are ready to measure the turbidity of the water. When deploying the secchi disc, try to test water at a shady side of a dock or a boat so the sunlight doesn't obstruct your view. The contrasting black and white quadrants help you see the disc in the water. To perform the measurement, you lower the disc slowly into the water until the disc disappears. You will be recording two depths. First, when you can't see the disc anymore, you pinch the line at the water line, and then you lift the disc up until you can see it again and pinch the line again. The average of these two readings is your secchi depth. And based on these markings, is just under 1.5 meters. The deeper the secchi depth, the clearer your water and less turbidity. The shallower your secchi depth, the more cloudy the water and higher turbidity. Now you can go to the same location over a period of time and measure the turbidity to see how different weather patterns may impact your water quality. If you're interested in this lesson plan, head to our website at sailorsforthesea.org and click on Kelp. We also have 50 other amazing activities to teach our children about the oceans. Thanks so much for joining today. I'll see you next time.